So the boat will now start a demonstration for you. Here goes the boat. It's got a crew of four. It's an antique 85 inshore lifeboat called the Sheila Stenhouse, which has been with us since December 2006. Our antique 85s have had service for around 20 years, and it's so well looked after. She normally carries a crew of four, but if it's a really pressing emergency, perhaps somebody in the water. As the first crew have arrived at the station on D Walk, we will set off. If necessary, the boat has a capacity to carry 20 survivors. Our chairman, who lives on the tracks of the boathouse, has his own baby, so that in the emergency, he opens the gate for us. No matter if it's 2 o'clock in the morning, which speeds things up by about a minute. The boat's power climbing 2 15 horsepower outboard engines, giving a top speed of 35 knots, which is about 40 miles an hour. It carries 210 litres of fuel, which at full speed lasts about 3 hours. Even on a short rescue or a shout, the boat can use 40 or 50 litres of fuel, which in today's business is quite costly, so any donations you can make are very welcome. You'll see in the back of the boat there's a large flat pack orange bag. That's in case the boat capsizes, that can be inflated and pulled by the boat. The engines are also special that if the boat does capsize, they will stop. And once the boat is righted, we can press the start buttons and everything will start again. So if you are interested in joining either the crew, the short crew, or acting as one of our fundraisers, please just have a chat with anybody from the RNLI here today. It looks as though somebody's had enough with Ian's driving, so they decided to get off with Sarah this time. It's pretty cold in there. The average water temperature in the UK in the summer, if you're lucky, is 12 degrees. Anything below 15 degrees and you're likely to get cold water shock. If you want any advice on cold water shock or staying safe on or near the water, please have a chat with David and Annie on the RNLI water safety stand. We're just getting ready to recover Sarah from the water. On these inshore boats, it's all down to muscle. This is not an easy manoeuvre. River, you'll see the Workington lifeboat getting ready. They're going to take over from the Kirkcudbright in a minute or two. Last time we had a shout at 1 o'clock in the morning, Josh, much to the amusement of the rest of the crew, was found to be wearing his pyjamas. Thank you, Ian, Josh, Simon and Sarah. Fortunate today to have a visit from the Workington lifeboat, the Dorothy May White. This lifeboat is one of the newest, being a Shannon class lifeboat. She's an all weather lifeboat designed to go out in any weather, although the safety of the boat and the crew is paramount. It can get very rough out in the Solway Firth in an average sea. She's not quite as fast as the Atlantic, but she still do 25 knots, about 30 miles an hour, and has a range of 250 nautical miles at full speed. The Shannon's powered by two 650 horsepower engines with propulsion from twin Hamilton water jets, which make her incredibly maneuverable. Spin on the spot and the stop speed in less than 20 metres. It also means she can operate in very shallow water. And yet again, the throwing crew aside, and off they go. You notice the crew on the Workington boat wearing a slightly different kit. It's our all-weather boat kit that they do have access to the dry suit, etc., for when they need to move the water. this lifeboat will shift 1.5 tons of water per second through the water jets. Like all our lifeboats, she's self-righting, so if she goes upside down, she'll end up the right way again. And this way she can carry 79 survivors, which must be fairly comfortable. Well, I think they've made up, we're going to pick him up this time. Boats.